Universal Center for Renovation presents Historical Israelites. This is strictly for educational purposes and commentary. Of biblical and secular historical literature. So enjoy. Subscribe, like, and share. This family tree represents two members of the research group Universal Center for Renovation. Our family tree, paternal grandfather and paternal grandmother, father's parents. Black Cherokee Indian, paternal line. Maternal line would include Thomas Jefferson and Robert Fulton. Part 6. From Africa to the Americas, the Jews. 1619, Jamestown, Virginia. This day in history, August 20th, 1619, August 20th, first enslaved Africans arrive in Jamestown, setting the stage for slavery in North America. On August 20th, 1619, 20 and odd Angolans kidnapped by the Portuguese arrive in the British colony of Virginia and are then brought by English colonists. The arrival of the enslaved Africans in the New World marks a beginning of 2.5 centuries of slavery in North America. Founded at Jamestown in 1607, the Virginia colony was home to about 700 people by 1619. The first enslaved Africans to arrive in Virginia disembarked at Point Comfort in what is today known as Fort Monroe. Most of their names, as well as their exact number who remained at Point Comfort, have been lost to history. But much is known about their journey. They were originally kidnapped by Portuguese colonial forces, who sent captured members of the native Congo and Ngango kingdoms on a forced march to port of Luanda, the capital of modern-day Angola. From there, they were ordered on the ship San Juan Batista, which set sail for Veracruz and the colony of New Spain. As was quite common, about 150 of the 350 captives aboard the ship died during the crossing. Then, as it approached its destination, the ship was attacked by two privateer ships, the White Lion and the Treasurer. Crews from the two ships kidnapped up to 60 of the Batista enslaved people. It was the White Lion which docked at Virginia's colony's Point Comfort and traded some of the prisoners for food on August 20th, 1619. James W. C. Pennington. James William Charles Pennington, born 1807, died October 22nd, 1870, was an African-American orator, minister, writer, and abolitionist, active in Brooklyn, New York. He escaped at the age of 19 from slavery in Western Maryland and reached New York. After working in Brooklyn and gaining some education, he was the first African American allowed to attend classes at Yale University, though he was not allowed to formally enroll. Pennington wrote and published what is considered the first history of blacks in the United States, the origin and history of the colored people, 1841. First African American allowed to attend classes at Yale. James W.C. Pennington. It is important to note that Pennington was never formally accepted as a student at Yale University in the 1830s. He was allowed to attend classes, but he could not participate as a student. Nor did he ever receive any degree or certificate at Yale. It was not until 2018 that the Yale Divinity School honored Pennington by renaming a classroom in his honor. The first black student to receive a degree at Yale University was Richard Henry Green in 1857. A textbook of the origin and history of the colored people by James W.C. Pennington, 1841. The Portuguese who planted themselves on the coast of Africa a few centuries ago have been succeeded by descendants blacker than the Africans. A stronger case still is to be found in the fact that the descendants of a colony of Jews originally from Judea to the coast of Africa are black. From Africa to the Americas. Journeys start March-April 1619. The Spanish slave ship San Juan Bautista leaves Luanda, the capital of Portuguese Angola, with approximately 350 enslaved Africans from the kingdom of Ndongo. As we have seen, there was a sense in medieval Europe that the interior of Africa was peopled in part by Jews in the form of the lost tribes of Israel. And this was particularly the case in the West African hinterland. It appears, however, that a specific connection had also existed for many centuries between the Lango coastline and Jews. Some 15th century European maps designated the coast near Lango the Gulf of the Jews, Golfo do Judeus, or Golfos dos Judeos. Speaking of the great voyages of the explorer Diego Cio, 1452-1486, the Anglo-German geographer Ernest George Ravenstein, 1834-1913, speculated It may be presumed that Cielo, in the course of this second voyage, gained a fuller knowledge of the coast first discovered by him and to the north of the Congo. He may thus have visited and named the bay called Golfo do Judeus, the Jew Bay of old maps, either because there was a Jew on board his vessel, or what is less likely, because he was struck with the Jewish physiognomy of some of the natives. Luanda, the Gulf of the Jews. Source, Homelands and Diasporas, page 9. Universal Geography, or a description of all the parts of the world on a new plan. 1825, volume 4. Black Jews, a fact worthy the attention of travelers, is that, according to Oldendorp, the kingdom of Lango contains black Jews scattered throughout the country. They are occupied in trade and keep the Sabbath as strictly that they do not even converse on that day. They have a separate burial ground, very far from any habitation. The tombs are constructed with masonry and ornamented with Hebrew inscriptions. Kingdom of Lango. Middle Passage. Slave ships called Guinea Men. Pirates of the Caribbean, July 1619. Before reaching the Spanish colony of Veracruz, the slave ship was attacked by English privateers, the White Lion and the Treasurer. Instead of gold, the privateers found enslaved Africans, 50 of whom they stole. San Juan Bautista, the slave ship. Destination, Veracruz, Mexico, New Spain. The privateers, White Lion, Treasurer. After the privateers stole the enslaved so-called Africans, who were really Jews, they decided to head to Virginia. Arrival in Virginia, August 1619. After capture by the privateers, the Africans arrived in the new English colony of Virginia. From Africa to the Americas. 1619, Jamestown, Virginia. The Jew.